We are going to start a new chapter, square and square roots. I believe in lower classes, I mean in 6 or 7 at least, in 7, you have learned about square and square roots. So we are doing almost the same, but here in class 8 we will be doing little bit bigger questions. So I thought you know everything. Even then I am discussing what is the meaning of square and square roots. So square and square roots, in fact, they are opposite to each other. Means, look here, if I go for an example, square of 5. Square of 5 means 5 square. Means square of 5, we are taking 2 times 5. So it is 25. Now, if we go for square root of 25, what will see? What will get? Look at here. Square root of 25 equals to under root 25. Under root 25 means under root, we have to now factorize 25. 5 into 5 is equal to, single 5 will come, as you know, out of double 5, 1 5 will come. So this is the square root of 25. Look here, we have started from 5, we have reached to 25, getting square of 5, and here square root of 25, we are getting 5. So we can say that's why square and square roots are reverse process, means opposite to each other. Let me give one more example. Suppose square of 7 is equal to 7 square is equal to 49. Similarly, if you go for square root of 49, what will get? Look, so under root 49, now we'll get 7 into 7 is equal to 7. So we can say square and square root opposite to each other. Now let me start the exercise. In our syllabus, exercise 3A is not there, so we'll be doing from exercise 3B. Now, question number 1 of 3B has 5 questions. So, what is the instruction? Question 1, instruction is here, find by prime factorization the square root of the following numbers. So, first number is here, under root 2916. This under root symbol comes from the instruction square root. So now we have to go for prime factorization. So we will be doing factorizing. Prime factorization means we will be using the prime numbers. Prime number starts from 2, then 3, then 5, then 7, then 11 and so on. So we will start with 2 because last digit is even number, so we can do it 2. So it is 1, 4, 5, 8. Now again, if you go with 2, then we'll see here 7, 2, 9. Now last digit is 9, so it will not go with 2, it will go with 3. So it is 2, 4, 3. Now if you go with 3, because last digit is 3, so look here, 81. So you will keep on going. 3, 27. 3, 9. So 3, 3 is 9. So we have here under root, we will be writing how many 2s? 2, 2. So 2 into 2. How many 3? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 3 into 3, 3 into 3, 3 into 3. So why I am putting 2 as one pair? So that from each pair we can get one number. So when you remove the square root, 1 out of double 2, 1, 2 will come. Out of double 3, 1, 3 will come. Out of this 2, 1, 3 will come. Out of the last 2, another 3 will come. Now if you multiply, you will get the answer. So 2, 3 is 6, 6, 3 is 18, 18, 3 is 54. So this is your answer. So we can say square root of 2916 is equal to 54. Similarly, we will do question number second. Here, again the same instruction, square root of 2704. So 2704 will be factorizing. Last digit is 2. So we can start with 2. We have here, so 1352. Now last digit is 2. Again it will go with 2. 676. Last digit is 6. Again it will go with 2. So 2, 3 is 6. 2, 3 is 6. 1, 6. 2, 8 is 16. Again it will go with 2. So 169. Now if you look at the last digit is 9, so it will not go with 3 also. So we have to start with 2 is not possible at all, 3 is not possible, then we will keep on going, 7 also not possible, 11 also not possible, yes, last is 13, 13, 1 is 13, so 3, 9, 13, 3 is 39. So we have here, how many 2s, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 2s, so we will put 2 together. And 2, 13, so this 2, 13 also together, so out of this 2, 1, 2, out of this 2, 1, 2, out of this 2, 1, 13. So now multiply 2 to the 4, 4, 13 is 13, 4 is 52. So this is your answer, right? Okay, let me do question number 1/3. Here, square root of 7056. Again, we'll go for factorizing. Factorizing of 7056. Now go with, since last digit is 6, so it will go with 2. We have 3, 5, 2, 8. Again it will go with 2. 1, 7, 6, 4. Again it will go with 2. So 8, 8, 2. Again it will go with 2. 4, 4, 1. Now the last digit is 1, so it will not go with 2. So let's try with 3. 3, 1 is 3. 1, 4, 14. 3, 4 is 12. 2, 1, 21. 3, 7 is 21. Okay. Again, it will go with, since 1, 3 has gone, so another 3 will come, sure. It's a common sense. 3, 4 is 12. 2, 7, 3, 9 is 27. So 7 into 7 is 49. So now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 2s, and there are 2 3s, and there are 2 7. Okay, now out of double 2, 1 2, this 2, 1 3, 1 7. Now, 2 2s are 4, 4 3 are 12, 12 7s are 84. Now I'm keeping one question as homework. Okay, you try question number 4th, square root of 9025. I can give the hints, since the last digit is 5, it will go with 5. Okay, you try this one as homework. I'm doing the last question of question number 1/5. 1/5 under root 9216. So 9216 first it will go with 2, it will be 4608. Yes, it is correct. Then it will go with 2 2304. Then it will go with 2 1152. Again it will go with 2, so it will be 576. Again it will go with 2 2888. Again it will go with 2 144. Again it will go with 2 72 236 2 18 2 9 3 3 9. So many twos. One pair, and last three is the one pair, right? So we'll be going for 2 into 2, 2 into 2, 2 into 2, 2 into 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pair. 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's do. Two into two, and then last is 1, 3 into 3. So now we'll multiply to get the square root. So 1, 2 will come, this 2, 1, 2 will come from here, 1, 2 will come from here, 1, 2 will come from here, 3. So how many pairs? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there will be 5 twos. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, correct. Into 3. So 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, 16 to the 32, 32, 3 the 96. So this is your answer. Okay, let me do few questions of question number 2. Here, questions are regarding square root but fractions. Instruction is given here, find the square root of the following fractions. So first question is here, 25/49. So since it is square root, we have to put square root symbol. Now same thing, so 25 is equal to 5 into 5, 49, 7 into 7, since the numbers are quite small, no need to show here factorization, okay? So here 5/7, so this is your answer. Now let me do question number 3, and second question I am keeping for homework. So under root 196/484, okay? So this question you do as homework. I am doing third question. Square root of 1225/2025. So let's do here, you can do separately the square root of numerator, another technique. Here I have done together. Square root of whole means numerator denominator together. Here I am doing square root of numerator upon square root of denominator. You can do this technique also, okay? Whichever you feel easy, you can do that one. So here last digit is 5, so 1225, if you go for factorization, you will see there is 5, then 245, again 5, 49, 7, 7 is 49. So it will be under root 5 into 5 into 7 into 7. And here 2025 square root of that. So factorization, again it will go with 5. It is 405. Again it will go with 5, 81. Again it will go with 3, 27. So 3, 9, 3, 3. So let's do here. So 5 into 5 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, you can take out of 2, 1. So 5 into 7 by 5 into 3 into 3. Since 1, 5 is in numerator, 1, 5 is in denominator, you can go for cancellation. 5, 1 is 5, 5, 1 is 5. So what is left? 7 by 9. So this is your answer. Okay, question number two, 4th and 5th, I'm not doing today because these questions are regarding decimal number. So we will do in the next class. Thank you so much.